Hi, hello, welcome to Maths Medium. Today I came with exercise 5.2 from Lines and Angles from 7th class NCERT. Question number 1. State the property that is used in each of the following statements. So, here is the given figure. So, we have to state the property by using this figure and this statement. So, question number 1 in that, if A parallel to B, then angle 1 equal to angle 5. 2. If angle 4 equal to angle 6, then A is parallel to B. 3rd one, if angle 4 plus angle 5 equal to 180, then A is parallel to the B. See here, A and B is nothing but parallel lines, and we have to tell the parallel line with the transversal. So this is the transversal line. We know that transversal is nothing but if two lines are parallel or non-parallel is not the matter. One line is cut the two lines at a distinct point is said to be transversal. In previous videos, I already explained to you about the transversal and transversal angles made by the transversal and parallel lines. Check the description box for that link. Coming to the question here, if A is parallel to B, here A is parallel to B. Then angle 1 and this one equal to angle 5. So angle 5. We have to state the property. So this is corresponding angles, right? So corresponding angles is nothing but if you take a, if you close this side of the transversal. See here, this is upper of the A line. This is the upper of the B line. So corresponding angles of the transversal. So we can say it is corresponding angles. Corresponding angles is nothing but if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal then the pair of corresponding angles are equal. So similarly, if you take angle 2 and angle 6 also equal to each other, if you take angle 4 and angle 7 also equal to each other, similarly, angle 3 and angle 8 also equal to each other according to corresponding angle property. Next here, if angle 4 equal to angle 6, angle 4 is equal to angle 6, then A is parallel to B. If A is parallel to B, angle 4 and angle 6 are equal. These two are alternate interior angles. So, this is the property alternate interior angles. So this property is said to be when a transversal cuts two lines such that pair of alternate interior angles are equal, but they have to be parallel. So that is also I am writing here. The lines have to be parallel. So this statement is telling you alternate interior angles, angle 4 and angle 6. So interior is nothing but between these two lines is interior, right? So if you take angle 3 and angle 5 according to the this property, alternate interior angles, this is also angle 3 is equal to the angle 5. Next, coming to this, if angle 4 plus angle 5 equal to 180, then A is parallel to B. We have to tell this angle 4 and angle 5 equal to 180 degrees. So these are pair of interior angles. So the property is when a transversal cuts two lines, then the pair of interior angles on the same side of a transversal or supplementary is nothing but 180 degrees. We know that in introduction we already learnt about the angles, that is supplementary and complementary angles. Check the description box for that link. Supplementary, but lines should be parallel. Supplementary is nothing but 180 degrees. According to this property, transversal is this, and if you transversal cuts two lines, then the pairs of interior angles, so angle 4 and angle 5, if you take angle 3 and angle 6, these two are supplementary angles. So this is about the transversal made by a parallel lines according to their properties also. I hope you understand about this session. If you have any doubts, comment on a comment box, click like button and share my videos and subscribe my channel. Thank you.